Hi everyone. Today in this video we are going to discuss about Clomiphene. What is this drug Clomiphene? This drug acts as estrogen receptor agonist as well as antagonist. That's why this drug is classified as selective estrogen receptor modulator SERM. We have few of the other drugs within this category such as tamoxifene as well as raloxifene. All these are having somewhat similar suffix, and the suffix of clomiphene can also be represented as FENE instead of PHENE. So all these are selective estrogen receptor modulators. Even these drugs belong to the same category, but they are having the different clinical indications. Tamoxifen is one of the drugs which is indicated for the treatment of estrogen dependent breast cancer. So this drug particularly acts as estrogen receptor antagonist, thereby it inhibits the estrogenic activity at the breast tissue. And raloxifene is indicated for the treatment of osteoporosis. This drug, because of its estrogenic activity, it can reduce the demineralization of the bones, thereby it can reduce the osteoporosis. And finally, clomiphene is one of the drug which is used to induce the ovulation in the anovulatory woman. Similarly, another drug is there, letrozole, which is again used to induce the ovulation in the anovulatory woman, but this drug is not an SERM. This drug is aromatase inhibitor. In our previous video, we have discussed about the letrozole, and today we will discuss about the clomiphene, how this drug acts, what are the important precautions, side effects, contraindications of this drug, we will discuss in this video. So, clomiphene is used to induce the ovulation in the woman with polycystic ovary syndrome, PCOS. So this is one of the conditions where there is formation of ovary cysts within the woman, which are small follicular growth that can reduce the ovulation and produce some menstrual disturbances. And this syndrome is also associated with increased testosterone levels within the woman. So in these women, we can observe few of the symptoms such as menstrual disorders, menstrual irregularity, formation of acne, excessive body hair growth, and infertility because of lack of ovulation. So in such women, we can give the clomiphene, which can induce the ovulation and increase the fertility in the woman. Similarly, clomiphene can be given in the conditions like amenorrhea. So women with psychogenic amenorrhea, where there is a lack of menstrual periods because of any mental stress. Otherwise, amenorrhea caused by oral contraceptives. So post-oral contraceptive amenorrhea can also be treated by clomiphene. Similarly, the women who are having amenorrhea along with galactorrhea. So in all these conditions, clomiphene is given to induce the ovulation in the woman. Now let us see the chemical nature of this drug. So this is the structure of clomiphene. We can observe this structure is somewhat similar with one of the estrogen derivative. So this is the end structure. This is nothing but diethylstilbestrol, which is an estrogen agonist. So clomiphene is having the structural similarity with the diethylstilbestrol with a small modification within the structure. Here we can observe ethyl groups are attached to the ethylene bridge. But here one side chlorine is there and on the other side phenyl group is there. So clomiphene is a structural relative of diethylstilbestrol. That's why this drug is having both estrogenic activity as well as anti-estrogenic activity, and it acts as mixed agonist antagonist. So now let us give the naming to this clomiphene structure. So here we can observe three phenyl groups are present in this clomiphene, which are attached to the ethylene bridge. So clomiphene is nothing but triphenyl ethylene derivative. But when we give the IUPAC name, we have to consider the principal functional group, and here amine is the principal functional group. So let us give the numbering here 1, 2. So simply it is ethanamine. To this ethanamine, on the nitrogen, two ethyl side chains are present. So this is nothing but NN diethyl. And to this ethanamine, at the second position, phenoxy group is present. So we can write this as 2-phenoxy. To this phenyl group, at the fourth position, ethylene bridge is present, which is having a chlorine group at the second position. So we can write this as 4-2-chloro. And phenyl groups are present at first and second position. So 1,2-diphenyl. So 1,2-diphenyl ethinyl. That is the complete name of clomiphene. Now let us see how this drug acts. One of the important action of clomiphene is on the HPA axis. So this is the hypothalamus and this is the pituitary. This pituitary can release the gonadotropes which are acting on the ovaries. Now from the hypothalamus, one of the important hormone that is going to be released is the gonadotropin releasing hormone. This gonadotropin releasing hormone can act on the anterior pituitary such that it can release two types of hormones. One is the follicle stimulating hormone and second one is the luteinizing hormone. So these hormones are going to be released and they can act on the ovary such that they can produce follicular growth and finally they result in the ovulation and lining of the corpus luteum. During this follicular growth, estrogens are going to be released from the ovaries which are going to control the release of gonadotropes by negative feedback mechanism. These estrogens can act on the estrogen receptors present on the hypothalamus as well as anterior pituitary. So here estrogen alpha receptors are present on the hypothalamus as well as anterior pituitary. Now this estrogen can bind to these estrogen receptors, thereby it can produce negative feedback mechanism which inhibits the release of gonadotropin releasing hormone as well as follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. So when these hormones are not released, follicular growth and ovulation may be reduced in the woman. At this step, clomiphene can act to increase the ovulation in the anovulatory woman. This clomiphene acts as the estrogen receptor antagonist at the hypothalamus as well as at the anterior pituitary, thereby it blocks the activity of these estrogen receptors. And when these estrogen receptors are inactive, the negative feedback mechanism can be minimized. So estrogen cannot bind to these receptors and cannot produce any negative feedback mechanism. So in presence of clomiphene, gonadotropic hormones are more released, stimulating follicular growth and ovulation in the woman. Now let us see the precautions of clomiphene. One of the important precautions of clomiphene is that this drug can produce some visual disturbances. These visual disturbances can be observed after a few days of the treatment and patients may observe few of the symptoms such as blurred vision, visual aura, some flash spots and some wavy forms can be observed. All these visual disturbances are reversible in nature. So whenever the use of this drug is going to be stopped, the visual activity comes to normal level. So at low dose of clomiphene, the visual disturbances which are produced in the patients are reversible in nature. But these visual disturbances may be increased with increase in the dose as well as duration of the treatment. So at a high dose, used for long-term treatment, this clomiphene produces visual disturbances which are irreversible in nature. So care should be taken in order to identify these visual disturbances. And particularly at high dose, these visual disturbances become irreversible. So whenever these visual disturbances are observed in the patients, ophthalmic examination should be done and if it is required, the drug should be stopped in order to prevent further development of visual complications. And particularly these visual disturbances are more observed in presence of bright light. So when the patients are exposed to the bright light, they may observe some blurred vision and visual aura and some flash spots. Similarly, another important precaution of clomiphene is that this drug can produce ovarian enlargement. This is again very important. This ovarian enlargement may be associated with ovarian cyst formation. So in such conditions, this drug should not be used. So caution should be taken to monitor any symptoms that indicate ovarian enlargement within the woman. Few of the symptoms such as abdominal pain, abdominal discomfort, pelvic pain, pelvic distension and weight gain, elevated liver enzymes, all these indicate ovarian enlargement within the woman. Similarly, clomiphene can precipitate one of the condition, ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome, OHSS. We have discussed that clomiphene can induce ovulation by inhibiting the estrogen receptors at the hypothalamus as well as at the anterior pituitary. So this can stimulate the release of more gonadotropes which are going to stimulate the ovaries. So when these ovaries are hyperstimulated, it can produce one of the syndrome, ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome. In this condition, we can observe ovarian enlargement, which may result in ovarian hemorrhage as well as increased fragility, oliguria, low urinary output, pleural effusion, accumulation of fluids surrounding the lungs, which may produce dyspnea, difficulty in breathing, and pericardial effusion, accumulation of the fluid surrounding the heart, hypotension, pulmonary edema, renal failure, deep vein thrombosis, hypovolemia, GI disturbances, and some electrolyte imbalance can be observed in the patients. Another important precaution of clomiphene is that this drug can produce multiple pregnancy. So this drug may result in the twins when this drug is used to stimulate ovulation. But this drug can also produce some ectopic pregnancy, which produce the multiple pregnancy, which finally results in the failure of conception. For instance, clomiphene can produce bilateral tubal pregnancy. The pregnancy that is developed in the follicle tubes, which is ectopic in nature, resulting in the failure of conception. And sometimes intrauterine pregnancy along with tubal pregnancy can also be observed. So a risk of multiple pregnancy is one of the important precautions of clomiphene. So that's why this drug should be given in the selected women only after proper gynecological evaluation. What are the side effects? The important side effects are flushing, abdominal pain, bloating, nausea and vomiting, headache, and visual disturbances such as blurred vision, diplopia, double vision, photophobia. And this drug can also produce ovarian enlargement, uterine bleeding, some myalgias, as well as tinnitus can be observed within the patients. What are the contraindications? As we have discussed earlier, this drug is not suitable for all types of women. Women with polycystic ovary syndrome, otherwise with amenorrhea, this drug can be given to stimulate the ovulation. So this drug is contraindicated in the liver disease and in the women with abnormal uterine bleeding, because clomiphene can increase the uterine bleeding. And women having any ovarian cyst, the cyst formation can produce ovarian enlargement and other complications. In such conditions, again, this drug should not be given. These ovarian cysts are not due to polycystic ovary syndrome. So the patients who are having ovarian cyst not due to the PCOS, again in such conditions this drug is contraindicated. And in the women with uncontrolled thyroid dysfunction, again this drug is contraindicated. And finally, any known hypersensitivity towards this drug is again contraindicated. This drug can produce congenital anomalies. That's why this drug is contraindicated in the pregnant woman. So the women who are already pregnant, this drug should not be given because it produces some fetal abnormalities. How it is given? This drug is given as a tablet form and it is available at a strength of 50 mg. But before administration of this drug, proper diagnostic evaluation should be done in order to prevent any complications in the patients. So within the woman, estrogen levels should be checked, because with sufficient estrogen levels only, ovulation can be promoted by this clomiphene. Similarly, test for thyroid function should be done before administration of this drug, because in presence of thyroid dysfunction, this drug is contraindicated. And endometrial biopsy should be done in order to assess any endometrial carcinogenesis or any ovarian enlargement. So before administration of clomiphene, all these tests should be done such that the patient can be selected for the treatment. And for the selected patients, the initial dose is given at a dose of 50 mg once daily for 5 days. And this drug is administered at the 5th day of ovulation cycle. Based on the efficacy of the treatment, the dose may be increased to 100 mg once daily for 5 days. But with increased dose and increased duration of the treatment, there may be a chance of hyperstimulation of ovaries. That's why this drug should not be administered for greater than 6 ovulation cycles. So that's about this clomiphene. Clomiphene is a selective estrogen receptor modulator which is used to induce the ovulation in anovulatory women. This drug is particularly indicated in the women with polycystic ovary syndrome who require medication to stimulate the ovulation. Similarly, the women with amenorrhea such as psychogenic amenorrhea or post-oral contraceptive amenorrhea, in women with amenorrhea along with galactorrhea, in all these conditions, this drug can be given to induce the ovulation. This drug acts as mixed agonist antagonist and it blocks the estrogen receptors present at the hypothalamus as well as anterior pituitary, thereby it inhibits autoinhibitory negative feedback mechanism produced by estrogens. So when this negative feedback mechanism is inhibited, it promotes the gonadotropin release, resulting in the follicular growth as well as ovulation in the woman. This drug may produce visual disturbance in the patients, which are reversible in nature at low dose, but at a high dose, these symptoms may be irreversible. So, ophthalmic examination should be done if any visual symptoms are observed in the patients. This drug can also increase the ovarian enlargement as well as hyperstimulation of the ovaries, which results in the gastrointestinal symptoms and pericardial effusion, pleural effusion. So, care should be taken to monitor these symptoms in the patients. Finally, this drug can also produce multiple pregnancy, which is rare but a serious condition in the patients. This drug is given at an initial dose of 50 mg once daily for 5 days. The dose may be increased up to 100 mg based on the efficacy of the treatment. The administration of the dose is done at the 5th day of ovarian cycle. In order to avoid hyperstimulation of the ovaries, this drug should not be administered for greater than 6 ovulation cycles. And before administration of this drug, proper diagnostic evaluation should be done. And in selected patients only, this drug can stimulate the ovulation and reduce the infertility. So that's about this clomiphene. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.